Wibbly wobbly, timey wimey.
Please don't say that.
Say what? Exterminate!
Mercy is weakness. There will be no further compromise.
Welcome,
rubbish,
to another edition of
Metal Breakfast Radio.
Rubbish.
My name is David Ingram, and I was just videoing that.
Four.
And each and every week, I am joined by
Mr. Bob Thunder.
Hey.
And Dr. Diamond.
They call me Dr. Love.
And we're here to bring you
down
and get you through this rubbish. Yes, we're back. We're in the Gibbon room here at...
Gibbon room? There's no monkeys in here. Except us, of course.
No, it's the Gibson room here at Four Sound. There will be photos. There have been photos taken already.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so check it out. It's a smashing place. I'll do a... What's the...
360.
Yeah, 360. Yeah, thank you. I was trying to think of the other word for it, which I've just seen on my phone, and now I can't remember it. Seconds later, that beer's good. All right, but anyway, welcome to this week's show. We've got beer, we've got music, and...
We've got comfy chairs.
Very comfortable chairs.
Very comfy chairs.
And I've got to go to the toilet.
Oh, you bored our bollocks blue with this already.
So we better get
on. Quick.
I know, just you started. Alrighty, but this show, we've got an exterminate button.
Excellent.
And there's a bunch of bands who've sent some stuff through. Oh my goodness, I've just noticed who some of them are. Okay, well, are we actually going to exterminate, though? Well, who knows? Who cares?
We'll find out.
We'll find out, yes. Because they're actually, some of them are friends of mine. Oops. Oh well.
Oh dear, how sad. Never mind.
And then the second half, it's a choice of, I think, some from you guys, some from me.
Okay.
And we're hopefully going to try and get two shows done. Again, this is the new format we've got going on with a little more chat. So, guys, if you want to talk, knock yourselves out, because they're not in drink.
Ah, that's me. Okay. Good, yeah.
So, this first band, Crawl, they're from Sweden. I know, because it says in the thing, they're from Transcending Obscurity Records.
Yeah, yeah.
I know this because they always put the band name in capital letters and then the country that they're from in parentheses right after.
Okay.
So they're a Swedish band.
Good information when you do radio. Yeah.
It's a release called Rituals. It's 2 minutes and 56 seconds. Perfect timing.
Good.
And the song is called Black Ritual. Now, this is obviously the D-beat Swedish death metal that is very close to my heart. Both of them. I really do like this band, so I'm just going to switch the exterminate button off. Just for this one. The next one, actually, is going to be a bit of a curveball for you guys.
Ooh, nice.
I'll warn you now. Curveball. But let's get on with Crawl.
Now let's all get drunk and play ping pong.
This is Dick.
Well, that's one way of putting it.
A cock.
Ticks all my boxes from the get-go.
Yeah, it's very punk as well. Yeah, this is really good.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. It does have that punk element to it, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Oh, don't quit.
Almost forgot.
Going to take it that we're all quiet because we're enjoying it.
We are enjoying
very
it.
Very much, yeah.
Ending actually,
yeah.
So that was what were they called again? Crawl. And the song Black Ritual from their album Rituals on Transcending Obscurity Records. Just as an aside, thank you, Kunal, for the hoodie. I'm not wearing it right now, which is a good thing because this room is rather warm.
That's okay now.
It's better now. I turned the air conditioning on full.
On full, yeah, good.
Yeah. And I thought, it's going to be really noisy and loud. We won't be able to have it on when we record. But quiet as a fucking mouse, that
exactly.
is.
Exactly. This is for sound. Everything is cool.
Right. Except this room.
Yeah.
Until the air conditioning kicks in. Anyway, are we going to points on that one? Because I really just noticed that there's lots of Friends bands at the moment. So
you're going to regret that exterminate button.
Yeah, exactly.
So they're all fives. Yep.
Fives. Yeah. All right. That's sorted.
Yeah. So. Unless right. something's really crappy. You know, even Friends make crappy music now and then. So
now and then.
The button is there just in case.
You've heard the Download album, haven't you?
Oh, yes.
So, okay. That's sorted. Now then, this next song, there's nothing in the release field, but I'm not going to tell you anything about it anyway. Right. It's a curveball, because if I tell you the name, Bob, I think you'll get it straight away.
Okay.
Maybe you would as well, Kent. But I can say that the one person who's in this, I spoke about before we started recording. So you can try and think, who the hell was he been talking about?
We normally don't listen to what you say, so that's going to be difficult.
Thanks, Bob. Thank you very much.
Wanker.
But before I get to this, obviously, it is more chat going on. There's a gig coming up next weekend, week today.
I can't make it.
No. No, you said it's at, let me just see, I've got it on my desktop. It's the name of the street, which I cannot actually remember. It's Ragenhildsgade.
Ramhildsgade.
Yeah, Ramhildsgade. Yeah, that's one.
Ramhildsgade. Yeah, that's what I thought it was, but I just wanted to make sure. And it's not Ramhildsgade number one. It's just down the road from where I live. Yeah, I'm going. Ask me who's on. I've seen the lineup. I've seen all the bands, but I can't read their fucking logos.
One of those bands. A lot of those bands. Yeah.
It's called what was called a extremely rotten death metal.
Yeah. They're all really underground bands. I've never even seen the logos around before, so I'm quite looking forward to this gig. So we'll see how that goes.
It's probably a load of rubbish.
Oh, yeah, just taking for photo for
okay
for references. For
a photo for posterior.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so while you're playing David Bailey over there.
Who photographs kebabs?
I will put this on. I will tell you that the song's called Out of My Mind. There you go. Oh, and also it's 5 minutes and 18 seconds.
Oh, no. Whoa.
I'm disappointed in you.
Yeah.
Again.
My girlfriend is a squirter, and it flooded the whole basement.
Thank you.
got to be a Sabbath with Ian Gillan.
It's not Sabbath with Ian Gillan.
Oh, it sounds like Ian Gillan.
It's Ian Gillan.
Okay, now so the Who Cares or something.
Yes.
Like, oh, okay. Yeah.
Yes. That's why I didn't want to say who it
no,
was.
No, no, yeah. But remember this, his voice. I can hear that anywhere. Like his voice is so distinctive.
Yeah.
For me, as a huge Purple fan. So.
Yeah. You know this, Ken?
No, I don't. It's from it's him solo, or what is it?
It's Ian Gillan and Tony Iommi back together doing some stuff. For, it's like a charity thing, and they put on a bunch of other tracks from their other bands in there as well.
Ah, was they did something for Armenia?
That's long before that.
Ah, okay, yeah. It's good.
Yeah. This isn't rock history. It's fairly new.
Yeah.
I can't remember. It's some years old, but I can't remember exactly.
It's about 3 years old.
Yeah, right? Something like that. Yeah, sounds about familiar.
Because when I heard about it, I didn't know.
Ah,
it was just a couple of weeks ago I found out. And when I heard about it, I was like, what? Ian Gillan and Tony Iommi again?
And you just came when you heard that.
Yes, I like, did, actually.
Who's doing the keyboards?
No idea.
Yeah, I can't remember. And I can't remember who plays drums or bass or anything. I can't remember.
What I got from it was that it was advertised as Gillan and Iommi.
Yeah.
And I think the other guys were just sort of session musicians.
Yeah, more or less. Maybe some really famous...
famous session musicians there. Because there are
those out there.
Splendid.
That was awesome.
Yeah. I mean, since I got that, I've not played it. I've been waiting to play it on the show.
Ah, so it's the first for you, this?
Yeah. But yeah,
I can see here that it was formed to help Armenia originally.
Okay.
Okay, also. Okay.
Yeah. And it used to feature Jon Lord on keyboards.
Okay.
Wasn't that the old one?
That was the old one, yes.
Yeah, the Rock 8 Armenia, that was the old one.
I remember that one.
Yeah.
But this is pretty recent.
Yeah, this is pretty recent.
That was just brilliant stuff. I loved it. I really did.
Actually, it says that... it's not on... Jon Lord died 3 days after the album's release, making it his final recording.
I can't... I've probably read about it somewhere, but I've got so much information in here in my skull, so I can't have room for everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was just... There was something about the sound. I said...
I'll probably remove the gay guy comment then. So, all right. So now, folks, you're going to wonder what I said now, aren't you? Yeah. All righty. Well, that was Who Cares and the song Out of My Mind. That features John Lord and Ian Gillan on vocals, John Lord on keyboards, of course, and Tony Iommi on guitar, who we don't want to ask how he masturbates.
That was very untasteful. That was or distasteful, that's what it was.
It was bad.
It was bad, yeah.
Yeah. All righty. So the next band, I think one of you guys chose this. It's Caro, C-A-R-O, a Danish band. I believe one of you chose it because it was in that list I had that got all messed up. It
doesn't ring a bell for me, but
that was named Bob
could
and Kent.
Could have been me.
It's from their release, Sever the Sixth Head. God, try saying that when you've had a dream. Oh, for fuck's sake, it's the title track, and I'm not saying it again. Yeah. Also, a couple of months ago, I did. There's this thing on Facebook, the Satanic Players Society, and there's about horror and things like that and writing. Mm. And I was talking about horror books and this video that I was doing. And at the end, I sort of reimagined the song Child of Sin by Benediction. I wrote the lyrics for it. So I reimagined it as a short story.
Oh, yeah, I heard that one. Yes.
And I sort of used the lyrics and sort of expanded them somewhat. Yeah, but again, when I got to the end, the last two lines, or the actual last line of the song, and I'd done this great video, and I didn't want to go back and do it again. I thought, fuck it, I'll just leave it. But I couldn't say the word vicious.
Ah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
And I was, what I actually said was vicious.
Vicious.
And
vicious horse.
Yeah. And I was pissed at myself because I got through the whole thing and then fluffed it right at the end. I was like, nope, I'm going to fucking leave it. I'm not doing it again. But yeah, it's online somewhere. Look up Satanic Players Society, Dave Ingram, on YouTube if you want to see it, if you're interested in hearing that version. I should probably record it again. I think I've still got the actual text.
Yeah, I wrote it down.
Maybe I'll just do an audio version of it and tack it on Metal Breakfast somewhere.
Good idea.
Yeah, that'll be cool.
Yeah, I can't do it now because I can't fucking remember it. And I can do several takes on the word vicious. All righty. Bloody speech impediments. That's just because of the beer, though. All right, so Caro and that song that I'm not going to repeat.
Okay, yeah.
I generally forget things because all my brain cells get killed by alcohol and repeated blows to the head.
Are you sure your laptop didn't come up with that one on its own? Because if you look at it at the back, it has a sticker that says Caro.
Yeah, it does. I didn't put the sticker on there, and I just haven't been asked to take it off.
Yeah, I know. You bought it from someone.
Yes, it's secondhand because my other laptop had a problem with the screen, which I found out I can actually get fixed. It's just getting myself into gear to go and take it in.
Ah, cool.
So I'll have two laptops. Woohoo!
So you have a whole collection, a range of Apple products.
I've got so many at home right now. Thank you, Gene.
You've got as many as I've got stationary ones.
Yeah, I've got two stationary ones as well. Yeah, I've just got to work out the password for the one.
I think I've got 9 stationary in my place.
Bloody hell, Rob.
You computer geeks.
Yeah. But they're all old.
So are we.
Oh yeah, true.
My deodorant's crap. I can smell myself from here.
As long as we can't, then it's okay.
That's why I'm the other side of the table, is it? Yeah. To justify your actions.
like the music, but this part is a bit boring.
Yeah. The singer reminds me of one from another band that I knew from years ago. Donovan played on the show, got me into.
Okay, yeah.
I can't remember what they're called, sadly.
I thought it was over. Oh, damn.
Cheeky bastards. Cheeky Danish bastards.
Yeah, I don't know them, so.
Who gives a shit?
Alrighty. That was Caro. They're a Danish band. The song, Sever the Sixth Head. Yeah, I got it right. Ooh. And it was the title track from their album, which is called what I just said. So 3 minutes and 45, I got to say. Did I forget to say how long it was? Probably, but who cares? Yeah. We got through it.
We got through it, yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't half bad. It was all right.
It wasn't half bad. It wasn't half good either.
No.
It was
okay.
It was okay.
The solo windy thing, yeah, that was a bit boring. But that was, yeah, good.
Yeah. All right. We didn't want to blow it up.
No.
That's the good thing. Now, I'll sit back, actually. I've got this rather comfortable sofa I'm sitting on.
These chairs are. I mean, you get sort of a regal feeling starting to, you know, unleash the hounds, Smithers.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. And they're great for what we're doing, because the wings at either side are actually going to project your voices into the microphone more.
Yeah.
So and also, if Bob, if ever you want to get rid of these chairs, let me know, because I've got to have one of these. I bloody love these old. Leathery things.
But we're going to keep them, I think.
I know, but if ever you want to. Yeah. Just saying.
No worries.
And speaking about the rest of the room as well, we got like wall to wall guitars. Well, hey, guitars on two walls, and then on the other side, we've got like loads of amps and amp heads.
The stacks, really big ones.
The big stacks. And then up in the one corner, there's three pieces of artwork. You've got Ozzy Osbourne from Black Sabbath. Jimi Hendrix from the Jimi Hendrix Experience.
Yep.
And Sonny Bono from U2.
Yeah.
So, And,
That's 2 out of 3 8 bands.
Got nothing on there. I think Kent got it. Anyway.
Okay, I did.
Well, one thing I have got is to go for a Waz. So I'll talk about this next song. It's a band called Ectoplasm. I have no idea where this came from. But I think this is another one of those songs that was from you guys. It was in that list that was marked Bob and Kent.
It's got to be him. I've never heard of him, I think.
The only reason I remember it, not from the band name, but from the song title, Worthless Angel Meat.
Doesn't that sounds like something I would send through.
Yeah, and the release, Spitting Coffins. I don't know how they do that. They must have big mouths. But still. But it's 3 minutes and 8 seconds. Which is
that's within the limits.
That's within the limits. I like that. But also, Ectoplasma. That's the band name. What did I say? Ectoplasm.
Yeah. Who cares?
Yeah. Okay. Ectoplasma.
The ghost, anyways.
Yeah.
With all the ectoplasm.
I've got to get it right, though. I'm trying to promote the boys or girls. You never know.
Girls. Oh, yeah.
I'm not going to assume their gender.
Nope. Okay.
Get into trouble for that. All right. Anyway, 3 minutes and 8 seconds. Here's Worthless Angel Meat. By Ectoplasma.
Why are you dressed as the man from Del Monte?
Because I'm worth it.
We have eternity to know your flesh.
That's fun.
It's from Hellraiser.
Haven't seen that for a long time.
That makes sense if it was me, if there was a Hellraiser reference.
Ah, yes.
By the way, they're from Greece.
Did you look them up, or do you?
Yeah, I did.
Ah,
yeah.
Oh, well done.
Yeah. Good man, he's understood the format of the show.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
I'm not drunk enough.
Ah, sure, we could remedy that.
It sounds dreadful with saying it, I'm not drunk enough, but this is Metal Breakfast Radio, folks.
Yeah.
Plus, it's nearly 7 o'clock here. Like, it's been 4 o'clock for the last 3 hours. I've had 2 beers.
Yeah, but I brought some beers.
All right, then I'll drink that one very quickly and we'll go get some more.
Yeah. I started working for the tax people, and on a totally unrelated note, I got a tax refund.
Excellent. I said to you earlier, I got one back as well.
Yeah.
First time in 3 or 4 years.
I haven't got mine yet, so I have no idea.
We can go and check. We can check online.
Yeah, I can't be bothered.
We'll find out in, about 3 weeks, anyway.
Yeah, start of April.
If you don't get money into your account, it means you owe them.
Or we are even. You never know.
You never get even with those people. Like that.
Or close to even, you know.
That was a bloody rubbish guitar solo. That was bloody rubbish. You'll be bloody ashamed of yourselves. At least ashamed of your guitarist. And your singer. Blimey. That was Ectoplasma there. And the release Spitting Coffins. And the song Worthless Solo. Angel Meat. Worthless Angel Meat, sorry.
And... started out so well, and then it sort of went all over the place.
It sort of went bad after I opened the beer.
Yeah.
And, yeah, that was the signal to start taking the piss.
Yeah.
All righty.
Apparently, they were drunk enough.
Yeah. Well, now, I haven't asked you guys yet, but have you got any news yourselves?
Yes, like 2/3 of the Mess with Breakfast Radio being on tour.
Yes, you've been to England, haven't you?
Yeah, to London.
So how was that?
That was awesome. I think that was awesome. I don't know about it, but it
was great. It was really great. We did. I don't think I walked that much in. We did like 50 kilometers in the 3 days.
Yeah, four days, kind of. That was Wednesday, and then Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and a bit of Sunday. So
yeah.
So
yeah.
4 days altogether.
That's so cool.
We did about 50 Ks, yeah. So.
Yeah.
About 50 K and about 50 pubs.
We could manage 50 pubs, but we did a few.
We did our best.
Okay.
Some really good ones, of course, and a lot of good beer. And
really good
beer. Some good Indians as well. Yeah. Indian food. Ooh, the Punjab, yeah.
Excellent. Yeah. I'm going to have to, one time when you go over, I'll have to come with you.
Of course.
And we'll do like a Metal Breakfast Radio over there.
Yeah, we talked about that as well.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Like take
it, awesome.
Check it. Not this mixing desk.
No, take something smaller, you know, and just set it up and have fun, you know.
Which means I'm going to have to buy a smaller one. Like, yeah. We'll have to go around and have a look in the other department.
Oh, yes. No, it's downstairs, but yeah, we'll sort it out. Something lightweight and small. And
yeah, small, lightweight, compact and bijou.
Oh, yeah.
So, any museums? War Museum, maybe?
Yeah, I did the Imperial War Museum.
Excellent.
Before I met him. He was just due to meet later that day, you know.
Okay.
So, like, just a past time I went there, and they redone it. And
what, the Second World War Part 2?
But the layout of the museum was redone, you know.
Okay, right.
And I preferred the other one. The old, like, it was okay, but it was not as exciting as last time.
Oh, okay.
Well, some good stuff in there, of course, obviously, but it's a bit boring. Because the layout is not exciting anymore.
Oh, okay.
All these new museums, I hate them.
Oh.
They start to cater for the younger generation with all their laptops and smartphones. Like, piss off.
Get off my lawn. Yeah. And, Kent, you enjoyed yourself. You sent me some photos from the comic book shop, Forbidden Planet, which is also one of my favorite places to go to.
Yeah. That's right. Yeah. I have to go there whenever I'm in London. Yeah
me too.
I bought, I sent you a picture of that, some 2000 AD comic books.
The Nemesis the Warlock.
Yeah, and stuff the skis.
Yeah.
Which I thought that was so fun, like an alien crashing in Birmingham.
Yeah. Yeah, it was like when Bob came to Birmingham a couple of years ago. last year, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
But we actually went to two comic book shops.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah.
There was one shop I forgot to tell you about. It's just called The Who Shop. It's all Doctor Who stuff. And in the back, you pay a couple of quid, and in the back they have like props and stuff from the TV show. You can actually just go in and have a look and look around. And I should have told you about it, because every time I've been to London, I forget to go because of other things going on. Unbelievable, I know.
How on earth could that possibly happen?
Well, the last time I was in London, I was playing a gig.
Yeah. Okay, so. That's... yeah, you're excused for that.
But. Yeah.
So
yeah.
We take the three of us take a trip to Metal Breakfast Radio in London and... go to for the Who Shop.
And to the Who Shop, yeah. I think obviously. It's still there. I do believe it is still there.
If not, we do a lot of pubs.
Yeah, we're going to do
that
pubs
anyway, yeah.
All right, up next is a band called Wombath. Now, this obviously features a friend of mine, Johnny Peterson, from Ursina, and formerly my bandmate in Just Before Dawn, until I left. Also in, Henry Kane and Nat Raunen. And
a lot of other bands.
Yeah.
This comes from the Wombath release, The Great Desolation. It is 3 minutes and 11 seconds. The song Harvester of Sin. And now you've suddenly got that Metallica song in your head, haven't you guys? Yeah, because I did as well when I first heard that song title. But anyway, this is far better than that song. And you can actually hear the bass on this one as well.
Oh, excellent. Yeah,
so here's Wombath and Harvester of Sin. And we're going to need some more beer.
Piss off for a beer is my answer.
How many beers have you had?
I saw on Facebook that he was doing something with Roga as well. Johnny...
He works a lot with Roga. I mean, Johnny's playing bass on the Troikodon album that Roga's playing guitar on.
Ah, okay, because he said something. He was changing his guitar then, and he was doing a project with Roga, and I just thought, you know, just when they're doing the credits, just the... From line,
yeah.
With all the bands they're in, that's going to break the internet or something.
Yeah, they're basically we're all sleeping with each other.
Oh, you slags. It's
the best way of saying it. Cheers, fellas.
Cheers.
Actually, please sit here, drink black gold, surrounded by black staff amps.
Yeah, it is.
Well, okay, got nothing.
The good life.
Yeah, and that wall that I'm facing, I'll take a photo of it and put it up, folks. It looks like Immortals backline.
Exactly.
Fake Marshall cabs.
But it looks cool.
Oh, it looks great in here. It looks terrible on stage for Immortal. Especially when the photographer is taking photos from the back.
Oh yeah.
Up the man. Oh, sorry, wrong harvester.
But There was actually in the Star Wars comic book, there was a Harvester of Sorrow. It was something the Empire was using to destroy, not whole planets, but parts of planets.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Well, now you know.
Comic books.
Yeah.
The Star Wars stuff is obviously the main movies for me, and audiobooks.
Oh,
I love listening to audiobooks from, you know, Star Wars, even stuff like Spider-Man. I've got a Spider-Man audiobook to listen to.
Okay.
It's weird.
Yeah.
Now, here's something. Just before I get into this, that was Wombath and the song Harvester of Sin from The Great Desolation. Sorry, I better get that.
Yeah.
Before we go off on a tangent, as we
normally do.
me, usually do. But now there was this Doctor Who audiobook.
Yes.
And in this audio adventure, the Doctor was facing off against the Weeping Angels.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
And if you know those ones, they sort of, you have to look at them, and if you blink, they move very quickly.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's audio. So how do you translate those creepy monsters on audio? And the thing is, it was one of the scariest fucking audio books I've ever heard.
Okay.
I did it really, really well. It must be so difficult for the writers to actually convey this audibly as opposed to visually. Because visually, you sort of turn the lights off quickly and they move them and they're closer and they're right in your face. But how do you do that with audio?
Like...
Yeah,
something like that.
And it was it was excellent. It really was.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Good. It was a bit like the BBC that did the case of Charles Dexter Ward, but it was done like some sort of NPR radio show where they were investigating something.
Oh, okay.
And then the one reporter, she was inside this trailer park home,
okay.
She found out that there was something leading down underground, and so she says, like, she's walking around like she's talking into her phone, and then she said, I'll just open this, I'll just put my phone over here, and then you hear some while she's away from the phone, and then every time she puts the phone down, there's a thing there, and that really freaked me out when I was listening to it.
Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah. I don't know. Charles Dexter Ward, that's Lovecraft.
That's
right?
Lovecraft, yeah. Yes. Yeah, yeah. But it is so they do it as a sort of more modern adventure.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, wow. I'll have to check that out.
Yeah, it's on BBC.
Okay. I'll definitely check that out. Ooh. I'm getting goosebumps thinking about it. Yeah, another thing that I do quite like is... The one company that does all these Doctor Who stuff, they do a series. Well, not a series. They've done their interpretation of H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds.
Oh, nice!
But they have to call it something else. I don't think they could get the full rights for it. So, and that right now, what's brought that to mind is Bob's tripod on his camera.
Yeah.
It actually looks like the Martians.
Yeah, exactly.
It looks like one of their sex toys. That looks like anal beads. Honestly, this is Martian anal beads we've got here on Bob's camera tripod. I will take a photo of that as well. So, there we are. All right, so...
I can only say one thing. Oola!
Oola!
You remember?
Oh, well, yeah.
I can't say it the right way, but...
That's what they said when they were using it. Pull them out too fast. Oola! Oh, dear. Okay, up next is a band called Minotaur Head. That's pretty sexy as well. It's 4 minutes and 45 seconds. I'm sorry.
It's pushing it.
It's the album Minotaur Head. This features... Roger Johansson and Bob Backus, Bob Backus, former drummer for Asphyx, who's now in Infidel Reich and I think Soulburn as well. But he's doing a lot of stuff. Yes, but the song is called Drowning Life. 4 minutes and 45. Sorry, this is actually one of the shorter ones. On this
okay, okay.
So there you go. So, but let's give it a try. Minotaur Head. It's a good name for a band.
Oh yeah.
Hmm.
Oh, yeah.
I'll say that.
As you might say up north, oh, well, I'll just go tuck foot at stairs. Bye-bye, gum. Or not good. Right.
guarantee you now there's no blast beats in this.
Okay. The one that's going to last so long is you put it on the wrong speed. No smoke and
mirrors. This is the 21st century, Bob. This is digital.
Okay, I thought like I thought you put it in 33 instead of 45. Yeah, fair enough.
Slippery and wet. And for those of you listening,
and those of you who didn't hear that, that was me dropping my phone. Yeah, that beer's good.
I actually like this. What album did you say that from?
It's the Minotaur Head album. It's just self-titled.
Okay.
I think it's the only one they've done.
Ah, okay.
Lazy bastards. Couldn't come up with a good title. Very much like a solo from the 70s, very acid.
Yeah, very, very Hendrix.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
It's no wonder Hendrix's solo sounded like that. His guitar was always on fire.
It also turned upside down.
Yeah, that was that as well. Did he have the strings upside down as well, or were they...
Nope.
So they were...
As far as I remember, they were the thick ones on the bottom.
Yeah, the E was at the...
At the C at both ends, so that really makes sense.
The fat E.
The fatty?
The fatty, yeah. The fatty was at the bottom.
What did you just call me? That was Rogger singing. Didn't sound like him.
For your listeners, look it up, find out,
and then write and tell us. Although I could just write to Rogger and say, was that you singing?
Did you just sing now?
That was Minotaur Head from the self-titled release and the song Drowning Life. So there you go. Check that out if you like it. It's a good album.
That's a good track.
Yeah, I think that is the shortest song on the album. But I just wanted to finally play some. because I've had it for a while and we haven't played any on the show.
Just
excuse me a moment. I needed to get that out. Sorry. Didn't want to do it on microphone. So. Now then, how far are we? Okay, I can see that we've talked quite a fair bit, so we'll keep this little link, this interlude here, short, and we'll get on with the next band, yeah. Who are VHS. And one of you guys posted...
That's got to be me. That's a long time ago I posted it, but
You pushed this on to me, which is fine. Yeah. It's awesome. Because I did some vocals with these guys. This is the previous album, I believe. Screaming Mad Gore is that album. The song is 1 minute and 49 seconds.
Nice.
It's very, very nice. The song is called, and I really do like this, Weight Reduction Through Terror. So basically, you're going to shit yourself thin. I love that. That's excellent. But I did a song with them, From the Scrapyard to the Graveyard was the song.
Oh, yeah.
There was another one as well that I did, but that one, that Scrapyard to the Graveyard, was used in a movie soundtrack.
Oh, nice.
And at the very end of the movie, the titles come up, that song plays, and the guy who was in the band went to the cinema to see the premiere of it and secretly filmed the titles because he knew where the song was.
Oh, yeah.
And put it up on Facebook, and I was like, holy fuck, that's my voice. I mean, I was only doing guest vocals on there. Mm. It's like, that's my voice. Yeah. In a fucking movie. Like, I was so pleased about that.
I think we're going to cut a song because we talk a lot.
Yes. Yeah, we are talking a lot. So let's get on with this. Luckily, it's only 1 minute and 49. Well done, Bob. But his VHS and Weight Reduction Through Terror. Sorry, that was a bit dramatic, wasn't it?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. I'll just put the song on.
I just shit myself.
You've lost weight.
Excellent.
You sweaty, overweight, has-been wanker.
Tune that snare.
Yeah, exactly.
Is it a fucking plumber?
I think it was Lars Ulrich.
Was VHS there and Weight Reduction Through Terror from their Screaming Mad Gore album. Brilliant stuff. I'd give that a 5 anyway.
Oh yeah, same here.
About 2-3 months ago, maybe 4-5, I don't know, can't remember because I've been drinking. I got sent through a bunch of VHS CDs.
Okay.
And if I get double ups, I'll let you guys sort it out.
Bring it on.
All right. I need to go through. I've got a pile of stuff that I've got sent through the post, and I just haven't sorted through it yet. Some of it needs CD covers and that. So
just bring it to me and I'll sort it out for you.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure you will. All righty. We're at the end of the first half of the show.
Oh.
Wow.
Okay, that sounded like a...
Yeah. And it's time for us to say we'll see you on the second half, I think.
Yeah, good idea.
Yeah, it really is a good idea. So with the usual chin-chin and...
Toodle-bye.
Pip and
toodle. See you on the other side.
Yeah, and definitely check out Big Mark's review, which is coming up on this...
Oh, nice.
And I have absolutely no idea what it is. So enjoy that. Enjoy the promos and check out the other shows. And we'll catch you in the second half in a few moments. Well, which would be minutes, actually. Just have another drink. Yeah. Good idea, yeah?
Yeah, good idea. Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
He's gobbled all the things up.
Cock.
Wet Soapy Boy.
RadioFreeSatan.com.
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 RadioFreeSatan.com. We play the tracks we want to hear.
Would you like to introduce yourself for the camera?
Hello, Gwen Cooper. I'm your victim.
Coming soon from Big Finish Productions, Torchwood, Night of the Fendahl.
We have lived for one thing and one thing alone. We are mere cattle, morsels for our masters.
This is the place. The actual place, this is where it happened all those years ago. And this is the altar. This is where I'm sacrificed.
You are a glorious gift as we summon death itself. I spin around forever.
Say its name. Say its name. The Fendahl.
Big Finish. We love stories.
Clint Mephisto coming at you, two-fisted from the Double Cross Ranch. Got a beer in one hand, a microphone in the other.
What, are you in love with my ass or something?
The Shake Higgin Road Show, the finest in rockabilly, psychobilly, vintage country, swamp rock, surf rock, doo-wop.
Well, man, it is now official.
Shake Higgin Road Show, Radio Free Satan.
This is Reverend Gene, the host of Vox Satane, exclusively on Radio Free Satan. Join me every week as we indulge in the classical side of music spanning the past 1,000 years. Vox Satane has already featured over 700 composers covering medieval, baroque, classical, romantic, and contemporary music, including chant, choral, opera, keyboard, and orchestral music, with composers ranging from Gluck to Gilmour, Bach to Bellavance, Talis to Taverner, and Paganini to Pärt. Get your weekly recommended dose of classical music right here on Vox Satane, only on Radio Free Satan, with me, Reverend Gene. Hail Satan.
The Conti and Kenny Show.
I just got a text message from Dave Ingram.
Oh, really?
Yep. You know, Kenny once told me the best thing about fucking 45-year-olds was that there's 40 of them. Your boy, Pip.
Oh, he sends me little jokes, too, now. He's like at work. He's just like, me and him would text back and forth or something like that, and then after that, he just sends me little jokes.
That's the master, Dave Ingram, from Metal Breakfast Radio. Great podcast. Go to metalbreakfastradio.com.
Great pal,
and
too.
Check out their podcast. It's such a unique podcast. It's so different than any other podcast you've ever heard that you should definitely check it out.
The Conti and Kenny Show.
Rev-
rabbit, 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 rabbit.
Okay, today I'm going to talk about the new album by the band Devil Master. This is called Satan Spits on Children of Light. Tasty. And it's on Relapse Records. Well, here's a big slice of frantic metal joy. Devil Master are a quartet hailing from Philadelphia, and they play an unholy mashup of blackened death metal and punk with a liberal dollop of goth rock. Think Nunslaughter playing the Mission covers. They've been around since 2016, and other than a couple of singles and demos, this is their debut full length. This is some ridiculously high energy, blasphemo metal, and is totally addictive. From the creepy Fulci soundtrack meets Scooby-Doo keyboard intro, which leads untidily into the first track proper, Nightmares in the Human Collapse, with its D-beat-driven riff frenzy, you know this is going to be a fun blast. This is like a Fields of Nephilim album played at 78 RPM, but with added metal and less flair and pretentiousness. Seriously, mate, you're from fucking Stevenage. Why are you dressed as a cowboy? Just reminds me of the pirate character in Dodgeball. Moving on. Zero parody here, though. These young Yanks are all about the Satan. 13, obviously. Mostly sub-3-minute toxic blasts like Black Flame Candle and Devil Is Your Master, let you know in no uncertain terms that the band have arrived and are more than ready to get all sacrificey on your ass. Nods to early Venom and Bathory abound, but Devil Master really have carved their own studied little niche. The production is suitably sloppy, but in a good organic way that suits the music 100%. No Andy Sneap knob twiddling here, just reverb-soaked vocals and guitars and upfront drumming that sounds very live, which is really refreshing in this age of digital fuckery. I reckon these will be a real joy to see and hear on stage. Some may criticise the lack of variety on offer here, but those are the same proctomancers that probably say the same things about Motorhead, so fuck them. I can't envisage any metal or punk fan come to that being disappointed with this record. This is a killer debut, and Devil Master are going to be a band to watch in the future, no question. 8 out of 10.
With your incessant choking, you're becoming a pest. Rabbit, 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 yep, yep, rabbit, yep, 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 rabbit, rabbit, bunny, jabber, rabbit, yep, rabbit, rabbit, bunny, rabbit, jabber, jabber, rabbit, rabbit, yep, yep, rabbit, rabbit, bunny, bunny, yep, jabber, rabbit.
My cock is falling off from the root.
I mean, chaps, I wouldn't advise trying it down your local swimming bath, swaggering into the changing rooms. Yeah. Morning, morning, ladies. I'm a lady as well, just like you and you. I'll just hang up my suit and my tie there, and I'll go and take a shower with all the rest of the... Oh, my Lord, my vagina's gone all stiff. Look at that.
Shut the f*** up!
Try shutting us up.
Will never happen.
And welcome to the second half of Metal Breakfast Radio for this week. Hope you're enjoying the show. Hope you'll enjoy the new format. I actually think that we maybe did talk quite too much on the first half. I don't know.
But
we still haven't had feedback from people on the previous show.
So no news is good news.
Well, yes, there is that. And folks, you can either send an email to us telling us whether or not you like the new format or just giving your views to lapdog1, L-A-P-D-O-G, numerical 1, at mac.com. That will come straight to my desktop where I will delete it. read it and then reply. And then delete it. You can go to radiofreesatan.com, and for the particular show that you're wanting to comment on, leave a comment there, because we'd really like to know if this new format is working for you, because it's working for us.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
We get to talk a lot more and drink beer, and then you know the music is we don't have to play as much rubbish.
That's good. Yeah, yeah. And also, like, if you like the show. Yeah. Let us know and donate money so we can talk some more and drink some more beer.
Yeah, that's the point. Yeah,
if you don't like the new format, still send us some more
money. Yeah,
money so we get some more beer. Then we'll change the format.
And the PayPal is lapdog1@mac.com. It's the same thing. It's all the same thing. All right, that's the PayPal address to use. So send beer money, beer tokens, whatever. Even just enough to buy one beer each is great.
That's fine. That's all we need.
That's awesome. That's all we want.
Yeah. Yeah. Like if all our listeners just send. Like £1 each.
Yeah, £1 or $1.
Dollar each. Or one shekel or whatever. Yeah. Like,
and we would end up with about £4. Which is nearly
enough for three beers.
All righty. So this band on the first band on the second half of the show is a Canadian band, America's Ooh, Hat.
Okay. Yep.
They're called Sacrifice. It's an old band. From their release Forward to Termination. The song is 4 minutes and 30. It's a little on the flong side, but it's all right. It's just in there. 4:30 was actually the limit we had.
Okay.
Right. After Devin fucked off, I changed the limit to 4:30.
Because no way we would get that passed on.
No.
Past 3 minutes, he was gone, you know.
Yeah. Also, there's going to be a censor bleep over his name. But not all of it.
No.
But anyway, the songs are called Forward to Termination, Oblique Stroke, Terror Strikes.
Yeah, if you go forward to extermination, the terror will strike. Yeah.
Quite probably would. Yeah.
Makes sense.
Why would terror go on strike?
Yeah.
I wish it would.
Yeah.
It would be nice.
It would be nice.
They would travel some more and bring beers and wine and whiskey on the planes and all that. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Not have to take off our shoes and
and belts and whatever. Yeah.
Yeah. And like,
whenever I go to fruit
security, we could use proper cutlery on a plane.
Yeah.
Instead of this plastic crap.
Yeah. But like whenever I go to fruit security, like it spells off, trousers down, and it's like a scream, you know.
Yeah.
That's what happens every time I go through. You know,
it's a bit
embarrassing in the long run.
And all I want to do is take my pump, axe, and shotgun with me.
Yeah, exactly.
When I try, it's my emotional support. Pump, axe, and shotgun. Look, I need it on a plane. It's not fair.
Exactly.
All right. So here's Sacrifice from Canada and Forward to Termination and Terror Strikes. And I wish it fucking would.
We strike for the greater glory of the Suntaran Empire.
Get on with it, eh? No, really, get on with it.
Twiddly.
And don't start that.
I'd say Operation Mess with Dave is proceeding according to plan.
Bloody Canada. This song has had three fucking intros already.
And two solos. It's a nice instrumental.
Ah, no, it's not. Sounds like a new duo, Terrence and Philip.
Terrence and Philip.
You got it.
The South Park reference. Nice one.
Arsenal!
All you can hear is like... you can hear drums and guitar mostly, and of course one of the singing, but that's it. You can't really hear the bass much. And we need more bass. New song.
Yeah.
This must be Terror Strikes.
Oh, yeah. Of course. very Metallica influenced.
I'm thinking this was about the same time as Kill 'Em All, but I'm not sure what came first.
Okay, nice.
I got a feeling this came first.
Could be. Of course, Canada's always on top of the United States, so, hey, they came first.
If you have a filthy mind, that actually sounds quite dirty. Canada were on top and they came first.
Ooh.
So Canada was on top and came first.
Came first.
And America was lying back just waiting for a towel. So that was Sacrifice from Canada. And the release Forward to Termination, the song Forward to Termination and Terror Strikes. Now, pretty good.
Yeah, well, I like
it. It was fun.
Yeah, it was fun to listen to, and also the conversation that went with it. That was
that's a person that surpassed the music by far.
Yeah. Well, I'm absolutely bursting for the Waz. So can we keep this conversational piece a little short?
Yeah, we'll do.
Excellent, because there is stuff I need to talk about.
Yeah.
I want to talk about it. I'm just going to have to.
So get off, Colonel. Go away and
let me introduce this song first.
Okay.
I was going to actually make this another curveball, but the thing is, as soon as the riff kicks in, you'd have known it. I think Kent would as well. It's Y&T.
Ah, okay, okay.
And I was playing this yesterday in the kitchen because our dishwasher at home has just gone tits up.
Yeah.
And I actually find it very cathartic. I set up a playlist on my iPod, and I've got this little device in the kitchen. I can plug my iPod in and hit play, and it just blasts music out. So I set up this playlist of all heavy metal stuff, and this was on there, and the wife came in. She was like, wow, this is really good. And it's weird. The wife's getting into Dio.
Yeah, right? Okay, that's weird.
Dio, yeah. And Judas Priest.
Ooh.
And this is the woman that listens to Depeche Mode and... Depeche Mode.
It's Depeche Mode
if you're from Crew. But she also
Ultravox.
Ultravox
as well.
Yeah,
we're going to see Mitch Euro later this year.
Yes, we all are. I'm going as well because I quite like Ultravox.
I like him, but not to go see him live.
Well, this is different. It's sort of instrumental and orchestral and whatever.
Yeah, it's a remake of a Vienna thing. Yeah.
I'm going to see Y&T in Malmö later this year.
Okay, they're not playing Copenhagen?
No.
Wankers.
No, they only played here once.
Wankers!
And they were down the Rock. And actually, I had the whole band in this room.
In this room?
Yeah. I didn't have them like
sexual. I know.
I'm just making that clear. But they actually came over here the day after and visited our shop and was in this room. In this very room. Yeah.
So, while I'm going for a piss, I want you guys to try and think what Y&T actually means.
I know.
I don't mean what the band think it means.
No, okay.
I mean what we think.
No, okay.
All right. And also the audience. You can write in and tell us what you think it means. But the song is called Mean Streak. It's from their album Mean Streak from 1983.
And it's a great video for that as well.
It's a great song. And obviously the video as well. And my wife was really loving this. So,
It's a great. It's the first song I heard by Y&T.
Yeah,
I got into them very late, but the first I saw that video, like, oh, great music, great video, and now I've got all the albums, and I've seen them plenty of times. I love this band,
And also the vocals of Dave Minichetti.
His vocals,
they're awesome.
He's so great, man.
He's a great vocal. He's one of my favorite, but not the favorite.
No, But he's really, really good. You know, it's a really good band. So
yeah.
Go see him in Malmö later this year. Excellent. Everybody, that's really good.
Well, Malmö's not that far away. We'll talk in the break.
We'll talk in the break.
When we've stopped recording.
Yeah.
And after I've had a piss.
Yeah.
Right. Let's get on with this. Y&T.
What did you do New Year's?
My brother blew me off.
Do you know this, Kent?
I know of them. I think I heard of a few songs, but I wasn't ever like a big fan of them. Yeah, I know.
Shame on you.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, but it sounds great, but it was not something I listened to back in that time.
We were chatting before this was on. You have some...
Well, yeah, it was because you guys were talking about going to the concert.
Yes.
And then I checked my phone, and my co-worker Nikolai had posted that Artillery and Based were playing in Køge on the 16th of May.
Oh, wow.
I don't care. I'm going to see him on Wednesday, so...
you
elitist.
Okay. And then,
I'm going to the Dave Ellison from Megadeth Bass Talk, and then Arturi's playing support, so...
Ah, okay. Yeah, I can't beat that. Okay.
I win. Just a sec.
Yeah.
Shh. It's a great song. We talk too much over this song. We need some music. This is good stuff.
A fuck off.
And a solo, come on.
I said keep it down at the back. I'm not editing in any sound effects.
Crickets.
I just love this music. I like really like this band.
Yeah, it is good.
So now he's broken the mold. Like, he plays it on the show. That means I can do it as well. So you know what you're in for. I'll try to contain myself a bit.
No, it's the live version that does that.
Oh, that's the live version. Oh, that's, yeah. I've seen some many times live.
I was always waiting for it as well. Like,
yeah, that's right.
Yeah, but no, version. It doesn't do it. Like, so check out the live version, folks. It's just as good.
Ooh, it's better.
Yeah. All righty. That was Y&T. And did we think about what Y&T means? Young and tender.
Could be, yeah. It could be. Mm-hmm. My friends and tits. Yep.
But folks, if you can think of what Y&T means, send us your emails. Yeah. You know the address. I said it before.
We know. I know. But do you know? So send it in and donate money as well.
I think it's very Norse. It's Yggdrasil and Thor.
Could be. That's a good one. Good thinking.
I was thinking of something you get in a bar in Japan. Yen and tonic.
Okay, Kent wins this round. Kent wins.
We can't be that.
Yeah. Nice one, mate. Nice one. Now then. Bob, I want to ask you.
Yeah.
Because you're into doing models and stuff. It's all World War II stuff, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Have you been doing a lot of that lately?
Yeah.
How's it going?
It's going great. In about 6 months, I'm going to exhibit at the Rødovrehallen in Denmark.
Okay.
In Copenhagen, outskirts of Copenhagen.
Yeah.
It's going to be good fun.
Oh, awesome.
Good fun. Awesome. Very good fun.
Because you're really into the whole World War II thing as well. You probably know a damn sight more about it than I do, and I thought I knew a lot.
Yeah, but I do know a lot about all the history about it. Of course, I know what's going on, all that, but I like the making models of it, you know, trying to recreate some scenes from that time, you know, so it's good fun.
Yeah.
And no, war is horrible, don't get me wrong there.
No.
But he knows a lot. I mean, when we were in London, he was talking about, and there's this plane, but I need to make it, and just the tail is sort of off, it's not the right thing, and it's...
I'm a bit of a nerd, sorry.
Nothing wrong with that, mate, nothing wrong with that.
No, that's cool.
Yeah. But there's that you say about scenes.
Yeah, but like that dioramas or vignettes, or they call it, small scenes of things happening, you know. Yeah.
We have to remember, the American soldiers, they all had, different weapons.
Oh, yeah. The Germans, the Russians.
Well, yeah, of course, there was the Browning.
Yeah. Where's he leading at?
No, but it's like the Browning, the Thompson as well.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to think, and there's that fucking one. It was called the Grease Gun. What was the real name of that? It was called the Grease Gun.
I can't remember.
Yeah. Obviously, it didn't fire grease. Imagine if it did. Are you fucking lousy American? Look at the state of my fucking uniform now. I'll never get these fucking stains out. We're white power, but not in the fucking laundry, you know? Adolf will be so disappointed.
But also, in the modern world, in the future, grease me up, Scotty.
Someone's wearing a red shirt today.
Hey, stop it. I'm not going to die before the end of this episode. As long as I don't beam down anywhere.
Yeah, you should be safe.
I'll be fine. I'll be fine.
But
else I'll talk with a Scottish accent. A very bad Scottish accent.
Eyes on. Yeah, but I post some photos on our Facebook page. Do that.
Because folks, listen, Bob's work is really detailed. It's very, very good. He's very, very good. So we need to see
it's
some
not
more.
Not professional,
of this.
But I think it's pretty good. I don't post myself, but I'm a bit meticulous about it. I try to make it right.
Well, you should really blow.
And
yourself.
Of course, most of all, have fun.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Alrighty. Now, with that said, and on that great big disappointment there.
Yeah.
I mean, high note. We're going to move on to the next band, Samhain.
Samhain, yeah.
The release, November Coming Fire. It's one of you guys, and I think it was you, Bob.
Probably, yeah. I think could it be, is. Yeah.
It's 2 minutes and 49, the song November's Fire. It's a classic.
Yeah. What can you say?
A fucking classic. A flassic, even. And there's only one song on this second half of the show that I've put on. It's all you guys. It's from you guys. I don't care. Don't sort of shake your heads when I tell you what's going on.
That means it's a good show.
Oh, huh?
Okay, put the music on.
Yeah, let's put Samhain on. Bloody thing. Grease gun up your ass. All right, Samhain. Schmain.
TV queens with the knocker's biggest fire hydrants.
Songs really reminds me of the Young Ones.
Oh yeah.
How so?
With episode Bambi with the video Nasty, wasn't that on the?
Oh, that was the episode Nasty.
That was Nasty, yeah. With the song Video Nasty by
the Damned.
Yeah, that's like sounds very much like them, you know. Maybe I'm wrong, but it reminds me of that song. It's the same kind of way to play the music.
All right. Okay.
And once listening, who doesn't know what I'm talking about, yeah, see the Young Ones.
Yeah, exactly.
And not the Cliff Richard thingy.
No. Well, thank you very much. That's Samhain, Shmain, and November's Fire from November Coming Fire. And you were saying it sounded like The Damned.
Yeah.
The song...
Video Nasty.
Video Nasty, yeah. That's a great song.
Yeah, it's a great song. Just reminds me of listening to it like, oh yeah, that's the episode with the Young Ones and The Damned, like...
Yeah.
Took me back years. Back to the good old ages.
Oh, yeah. It was a fucking great song, that was. Yeah. So, Kent, how about you? Like, we need to talk more, a little bit, to promote the new podcast that you're doing.
Oh, yeah. We recorded again this Friday. Let's start at 9, as it's called. We did something about 12-factor applications, which, of course... tells people nothing, but of course I talk about comic books and popular culture at the end, so it's all right.
Yeah,
but it's in Danish, despite the title. I mean, it's a really bad pick for a title, I guess.
But it sounds a bit like "Lad os begynde klokken ni." That doesn't sound really good.
It was actually our Nikolai who's. He came up with the idea for the podcast, and he was doing some sort of workshop, and the guy doing the workshop said, "Let's start at 9, and our company is called 9, so it's
it's sort of a bit of a take on that.
Yeah. We had some live. Even though we don't speak English, we did have some stuff live from London because that was the reason I met with Bob in London. Was that I was going to the QCon conference, which is
a
software conference.
Gotcha. Nice.
Yeah.
Very nice. And a good excuse for a piss-up then.
Exactly. Bob knew exactly one guy on the agenda for the conference,
Yeah. Okay. I did my homework, you know, so I looked up. Like, ah, I know him.
Yeah, it's King Diamond.
Actually, King Diamond, tickets for his concert went on sale on Friday.
Oh, yeah, here in...
In Copenhagen.
Yeah. A friend of mine...
But it wasn't him, no. Ben Goldager.
Yeah, okay. But a friend of mine, he's putting the gig on here in Copenhagen.
Oh.
So I'm going to write to him and say...
we need a couple of tickets.
We need a few tickets here for the radio show that we will promote the gig for.
Ah, yes, yes.
So I'll have a word with him.
It's always good leverage, you know. We promote it on the...
Yeah. Alrighty.
So I already bought mine in. There was an early pre-sale if you already had bought something from whoever sells the tickets.
Okay.
Got a link on Thursday.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Excellent. Excellent. Well, we will endeavor to go and see King Diamond this year.
Oh, yes. I've seen Ben Goldacre. That would be fun.
Yeah, he was so fun. He's been on QI a few times. And I think
okay.
He talks about science, but he's totally funny. And it talks a lot about how people misrepresent things and try to bullshit you with wrong facts, alternative facts, and things like that. Yeah, he's really good at exposing things like that.
Brilliant. All right. I think when you said the name, it does ring a bell. And I think it's because I've seen him on QI.
Yeah, if you see his face, you know definitely who it is. Yeah. Like, that's him. He's funny, you know. And he's got a good point of view as well, so.
Excellent. All righty. This next song is the, or at least actually one of, the curveballs I said that was coming on this half of the show. So
exciting.
Brace yourselves.
Will do.
And so I can't really say much more about it, which is good because you guys spoke a shitload.
Yeah. Put on the music.
Let's do it. Alrighty. And also I need another piss. Sorry, guys.
I have never seen a duller bunch of pathetic bastards in my life.
Nice one.
Well, you were talking about it. I was exactly. Searching for it in my library.
Don't quit. That's a very good choice, mate.
Well, I've knocked out one of the other choices. I'll move it to another show.
Yeah, yeah, of course. Yeah, but yeah. This is brilliant. You're not so safe. And we just lost half of our listeners because it's not metal.
Well, most of them should be fans of the Young Ones.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I think so.
So they should enjoy this.
Yeah. If you don't, like, fuck it, because like, this is good stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
It's fun as well.
And that's from early 80s. Then,
yeah, 83,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
need.
I'm not a vampire. I'm a driving instructor. From the Transvaal. All right, now, that was The Damned and Video Nasty. From it was on The Young Ones, folks. Just if you have never watched The Young Ones, go and watch them.
You'll crack yourself up. Oh, that is so funny.
Gordon Bennett. All righty. Well, I knocked a song out for that one because you were chatting away about it. And I was.
It's a really cool choice, mate.
I was covertly going through my library, where's that fucking damned song? And found it and dropped it in the list and bingo.
Yeah.
Had to do that, yeah.
So far, this has been one of my favorite shows. Yes. This is it. Everything is...
I can tell. Yeah, I can tell. Now then, up next is a band called Death. That one of you guys put on.
Yeah, that must be me.
It's from the release Individual Thought Patterns.
Yeah, then it's me. Yeah.
It's 3 minutes and 19 seconds. The song Nothing is Everything.
No, and it's more like the usual show kind of thing. That's a good thing because we took a bit of a turn.
We separated something from the original.
Yeah. So at least if the audience are still here, they're going to be happy now. But after this song... they're going to leave again. And it's the last song anyway, so who gives a freaking fuck?
Exactly. Yeah.
But this is Death and Individual Thought Patterns. We're all right for time. We can have a chat.
Okay. Bit of a chin wag.
I don't know what about. I'm sort of out of subjects right now.
Yeah, if something has... no special gigs coming up, or we're going to, or playing.
We've started that one next weekend.
I'm going to see Eddie Izzard sometime in April. It's not it's not metal, but it's fun.
No, he's still funny.
Yeah.
It's good. When in April is that?
The 3rd, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, and a couple of days later, I think it's 6th or something like that. Impalers are playing in Amabio or Vega or something. I think it's Vega.
Okay.
That's a good band. Definitely go for that.
Yeah, yeah. What did you say? What day was that?
I think it's the 6th of April, I think. But
you only keep saying that only because I can't say it.
The sixth.
It's the sixth.
It's the sixth. Yeah.
Pair of you bastards.
Yeah. Yeah, but the Impalers, they're great. We've seen them.
We've seen them. They're awesome, man. It's a good band.
Where are you say? Well, was that Beta?
Beta, yeah.
Yeah, Amabio. It's been renovated.
It's finished now. They opened here last week or something. So now they're up and running again.
Yeah. Dead Rock is back.
There's also that band, Dead Men Ritual. With Geezer Butler's new.
They're coming too. Yeah,
got to go and see them.
Yes,
me and the wife will be going to that gig.
Me too.
Right, because that one song that they put out.
Yeah, Kent sent me a link, like, oh, check this out. So I checked it out, and like, maybe.
Oh, it's fucking great. That music is awesome.
Yeah. I loved the thing they put up.
It's like, it sounds a bit like Queens of the Stone Age, but it has that Black Sabbath bit in there. And do you know what? Black Sabbath and Queens of the Stone Age are my two favorite bands, so it's like fucking perfect. Yeah, I cannot wait for the album.
Yeah, I know.
And I know how much you love stoner music.
I hate stuff like that. And like Queens of the Stone Age, boring. But Black Sabbath's good. But
Queens of the Stone Age are not stoner music.
Whatever. I don't. It's just boring.
It's desert. Sorry.
Yeah, it's boring. I don't. I might go see it for the hell of it.
Right, can we have an exterminate button for Bob?
You could try.
Doesn't work. All right. Well, let's get on with the music. His death and Nothing is Everything. Does that make sense? That doesn't make sense.
It is true. Really.
When
nothing is everything except everything.
Which is nothing.
Yeah.
I want another drink.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, God, I'm talking a lot of cobblers, isn't I?
Rock, that's kind of...
Yeah, it is, yeah, it is, yeah.
Also the bass, like...
I like the first couple of Death albums. This is too technical for me.
Yeah, I was late in discovering them. What was the last album they did? That was when I really found out about them, and then
Symbolic. It,
later than that.
I can't remember.
No. The Sound of Perseverance.
That might be it.
Yeah, I think that was it. So I was used to this kind of strange thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like the solo, it's a bit El Demiola about it. You know him?
Who?
El Demiola. You know him?
It sounds like a garlic sauce, or is that alioli or something?
Yeah,
like
I'll have the El Demiola.
Okay.
I'll have the penne alla arrabbiata.
I just leave it at that.
I know who he is.
You know, of course you do. You're Danish, of course you know. No reaction from him. That's strange.
No, I'm just thinking about garlic sauce now. I might buy a pizza on the way home.
Oh, yeah. Nice pizza on the way home. Yeah. You might have a point there, mate.
Mm. I'm all hungry.
Oh, shit. The song's over. All right. That was Death. I'm sorry. With I've got beer in my mouth.
With the well-known song "Pizza Number 42,"
with garlic sauce. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes.
So the song "Nothing Is Everything" from Individual Thought Patterns. And just looking back, yeah, we spoke over quite a lot of that. Oh dear.
I mean, a lot of people who listen to the show know Death anyway.
Yeah, of course they do, and they can go and listen to it another way and. That's the whole point of the show, is to listen to our stupid
And it's a banter. Little bit of a music here and there, and then you're like, oh, sounds interesting. We look it up, and yeah.
And then we find out that it's all bollocks.
Yeah. Maybe.
Sorry. Alrighty, we're on the last song of the night.
Already?
Oh no!
Yes, we are. It's... Another curveball. Guys. I know you were definitely going to know who this is.
Okay, yeah. Kent is a bit...
No, Kent will. As soon as you hear the riff at the beginning, it's like I said with the whole, hand over your metal card.
Yeah,
everybody's going to know this. And if you don't...
No, you're water.
No, you... Never tell me the odds.
So... We You bastard, Bob!
Sorry.
I am silently swearing at this guy right now. But no, if you don't know this riff, then you do have to hand in your metal card and send it to us at a digital version, lapdog1@mac.com.
And send money for beer.
Don't send money for beers. Just send the card that you're supposed to be a metalhead. Because... We'll post it and make fun.
Okay. So.
Alrighty. This is... I almost introduced it then. Like a pillock. Alrighty. It's curveballs. So I'll get on with it. Actually, I need another pee. Say pee? I mean, I've got to go for a fucking piss.
I don't need a beer.
Yay.
Right. Just give me a glass and I don't
No, I don't want that.
We'll be right back.
riff sounds familiar.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, there's no sign in here that says you're not allowed to play it.
No.
Okay.
You're allowed to play this song in this shop.
Okay.
It's gonna cost you, but you can play it. Don't know that song.
yeah, but yeah, of course it's Smoke on the Water. But is it from the? I was thinking, is it from the John Lord?
It's live at the Albert Hall. Listen, have a listen, guys.
Hey Ryan, what do you think, Ryan?
Come on, Ken, get in the game.
Whoa.
Who is it?
It's Dio.
Yeah, it is.
Of course it is.
I know. That's exactly the same reaction I had.
Yeah. I just came in my pants.
I came in your pants earlier when I heard this.
Which recording is this?
I'm not sure. It's from the Who Cares?
Ah, okay, okay.
Release.
Okay. One of my all-time favorite bands. I've only seen them 26 times live.
Stop showing off.
On five continents.
No. In six different countries and in three different continents I've seen them.
Okay.
And I met most of the guys in the band as well, so thumbs up.
Did Ian Gillan sign your testicles?
I know.
Then stop bragging.
Okay, sir. Yeah, but then next to us, the next room, we had Steve Moore sitting in there one time, way back. I was interviewing him for a magazine.
And did he sign your testicles?
No.
I think somehow Dave is trying to talk us into looking at his testicles for autographs.
There are no autographs on my testicles.
That's what you say. But now we have to go check.
Judging by the music file I got on my computer, this riff goes on for about 20 minutes.
More than likely, yeah. come twice back in 86, in the 96 with the orchestra in Royal Albert Hall. Awesome. Bloody fucking awesome.
All right, maybe it's a lot of the crowd, which is fine.
Yeah.
But not for a radio show.
Nope, no.
So
no.
Hang on. Shut up, Ian. That's better. Keep it down. Alrighty. So we're at the end of the show.
Ooh, already. Ooh,
good no. grief.
I could carry on for hours and hours and hours.
Oh, I bet you could.
Oh, yes, I could. Got stamina, mate.
Oh, I am so sorry.
No, you're not.
Well, I am in a certain way because it's horrible to listen to.
Oh, yeah.
But I have to do it because since I'm the main microphone, although just a few moments ago you spoke to me and I had the microphone on my lap. I'm using a handheld tonight.
I was almost about to say, keep close to the microphone.
It's the first time I've ever fucking done it in 11 years. Yes. Oh, speaking of which, the 11th anniversary of Metal Breakfast Radio is coming up soon.
Ooh, nice.
So I guess that the next episode that we put out is going to be the 11th anniversary episode.
Wrong. Excellent.
Oh, my. All right.
There's a special guest then, maybe.
Yeah, and I think we've got time to record at least the first half of the show this tonight.
Like the sober part.
Wrong. Yeah, the better part, whatever.
Trust me, really.
Yeah. So we'll. I think we should do that next.
Good idea.
Yeah.
So then we'll be all in celebratory mood.
Yeah.
Wrong. That really doesn't sound very celebratory.
Hey! Much rejoicing. Yay!
Hey! Mazel tov.
Wrong. Okay, well, this has been Metal Breakfast Radio for this week. Next time round, we've got some half-arsed rejoicing going on. But for this one, we'd like to say thanks for listening, thanks for tuning in, thanks for, thanks for nothing.
Yeah, but really. Thanks for listening to a different show, but yes. Very music-wise, very different.
A different show, different music, different place.
Different place, yeah.
We're in the Gibbon room, Gibson room.
Room before sound, yeah. Good room.
And we've put the photos out.
Yeah, like there's leather armchairs and a chandelier and amps and guitars and even a carpet.
Yeah, because we were worth it.
Yeah,
exactly.
What? Even a carpet?
Yeah, that's...
What are you fucking talking about? It's just fucking human dignity with a carpet.
Yeah, but not in a shop.
It is. What are you going to have, like, fucking bare floorboards?
Did you see my
cobblestone?
You've seen his place.
Yeah, didn't you notice?
No carpet.
They are really nicely done floorboards.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. Professionally done. Over here, what we got? Well, we've got carpet that looks like the front end of a Black Star speaker. Right. And this rug that you think you're calling a carpet. Jesus Christ.
Okay.
This thing, it's seen better days.
It probably has, yeah.
It looks like it's sepia. Someone's been tuning with the sepia knobs on the colour of this carpet. Anyway, let's get on with it.
Yeah. On my nice mahogany table here.
This is not mahogany. <It's>
okay. I think Dave is grumpy and he needs a nap.
I need this sofa.
Yes.
In my apartment.
Okay, we'll talk about it.
Or at least one of them chairs. Yeah. Either way, I don't mind. Either or all. In fact, the lot. It's time for us to go. So, what do we say? We say chin chin.
Toodle pip.
Chitty bye.
Wizard prank. Bucket of
cock.
Ow. You know.
Oh, sorry, mate.
Stop hitting me. All right. I said stop. Alrighty, we'll catch you on the next one. And until then, hail
Satan! And all his friends.
Hang on, I'll give him a call. I've got his number.
666.
That's my number.
Oh, that's your number. Okay. So, 616 then.
668. It's the neighbor of the beast.
Neighbor of the beast, yeah. I told you that last time, yeah.
Mm. Yeah, but when I said it, it was
funny. Funny, yeah. Typical. Typical.
Sunshine in your smile, bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years, never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love.
There will be no further compromise.
www.metalbreakfastradio.com.
Hey George, I got the new Madonna tape. You wanna check it out? Go ahead and pop it in.
Your heart is not open.
Oh, that's pretty good, right? I'm surprised she can even sing with 12 cocks in her mouth. Turn that cunt off!